Welcome to Practice Update. I'm Dr. Farzana Hafizullah. Joining me today is Dr. John Frederick de Groot from MD Anderson Cancer Center. Dr. de Groot is professor and interim chair of the Department of Neuro-Oncology. Dr. de Groot, what a pleasure to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
Excellent. I'd love to hear some of the best strategies from your own clinical perspective for treating elderly patients with glioblastoma.
So thank you for the question. This is a very interesting topic. We have a large number of patients who are what are considered elderly in chronologic age. And I think one of the interesting aspects of the way we practice medicine is we don't necessarily look at the chronologic age, but we also look at what I would call biologic age. So,
sure.
And what are the comorbidities of the patient? Even if they're 80 years old, are they out running 3 miles a day?
Absolutely.
And the world is changing. Patients are living older. We really are trying to treat the patients with therapies that we think are going to optimize their outcome, not necessarily just based on a numeric age.
Excellent.
So for patients that have good performance status and are doing very well, even though they're older than 70, we actually treat them with the full EORTC regimen of combining radiation temozolomide and adjuvant temozolomide. And we have many patients do extremely well with that regimen.
Would you only use temozolomide in patients who are MGMT methylated?
So we tend not to do that in our practice. I know that there are some centers where that is a directed therapy approach. We again tend to treat patients more aggressively when we feel like they can handle it physically and biologically.
So then you truly just sort of individualize, but you're aggressive in that individualization, which is important.
Yeah, that's right. We've had some patients, again, despite their old age, live, 3-5 years, even though they're older than 70.
Excellent.
And so I think that's a really important component of it. Now, obviously, the opposite is true as well. So if there's an older patient who has more comorbidities or is a poor performance, we tend to be a little bit less aggressive, and so we might use hypofractionated radiation alone. Mm-hmm. In that setting, again, we might use MGMT promoter methylation status to determine whether or not to give temozolomide.
That makes a lot of sense. So what are some vital pieces of information that you like to share with your patients prior to initiating such therapies?
So some of the most important aspects we feel are for patients to remain physically active, to maintain their strength and endurance, either through a defined exercise program or through physical therapy. We also ask the patients to remain very engaged, both mentally and socially. And this is where I think it's critically important to engage the family, who really made a central component to the patient's recovery.
That's a very important point. And do you have any special programs at MD Anderson Cancer Center that can help them engage in more of a community-wide support system?
So we do. We have a brain tumor support group called BEST. It's led by one of our faculty, Xiaopei Weathers.
Excellent.
And this is a really wonderful program that goes into the community, engages with social workers and various community support groups to help families and patients cope and to live through this difficult time.
And it's great that MD Anderson Cancer Center is able to do that and be involved in the whole process from start to finish. That's a big part of the healing process for
Absolutely.
Patients. And I want to thank you for highlighting that and for sharing your expertise and some of your perspective today.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. And thank you for joining us for this practice update. I'm Dr. Farzana Hafizullah.